Lisa Caputo and Jamal Williams remain with us. We're joined by Kellyanne Conway, president and CEO of the polling company, a Republican strategist, and our old friend Jonah Goldberg, editor-at-large at National Review Online, and author of Liberal Fascism, The Secret History of the American Left from Mussolini to the Politics of Meaning. We're going to discuss John McCain. First, guys, we're going to show you a tape of McCain's new web ad. It looks like a preview of his message for the fall campaign. Let's watch and we'll discuss it.
We shall fight on the beaches, we shall fight on the landing grounds, we shall fight in the fields and in the streets, we shall fight in the hills, we shall never surrender.
Keep that faith, keep your courage, stick together, stay strong, do not yield, do not flinch, stand up. We're Americans, and we'll never surrender, they will.
All right, what do you make, Kellyanne, of introducing Winston Churchill into this?
It's great for John McCain to be allying himself with such a strong historic figure, particularly at a time when Obama and Clinton seemed to be in a protracted knife fight, lacking in the kind of dignity and maturity you would think that would make a great president. And there's John McCain. I think he's the greatest beneficiary of what's going on the left right now. And for him to be able to be out there, Larry, and running web ads that recast him as the person who is truly ready on day one and in the mold of a Winston Churchill. And what he's doing, too, is for all those who are out there very unfairly and cryptically trying to accuse him of being too old to be commander-in-chief, he's hearkening back to other famous leaders in history who have been successful in war efforts, who have had that age and that wisdom, that experience, and that seasoning.
Now we'll talk about another side of him, his temper, and let Jonah comment. He got into a testy discussion with a New York Times reporter today on his campaign plane when she questioned him about whether he'd ever talked to John Kerry about becoming Kerry's running mate in 2004. Watch.
Everybody knows that I had a conversation. There's no living American in Washington that knows that. There's no one. And you know it, too. So, no, you know it. You know it. So I don't even know why you ask. No, you do know it. You do know it.
No, I just read it in the Times in May.
I don't know what you read or heard of, and I don't know the circumstances. Maybe in May of 2004 I hadn't had a conversation. I don't know, but it's well known that I had the conversation. It was absolutely well known by everyone. So do you have a question on another issue?
Jonah, that doesn't look great, does it?
No, it doesn't. And John McCain needs to be careful because he does have a temper. I mean, it's sort of a well-known fact in Washington. And I agree with Kellyanne to a certain extent that I think he's got this moment now. I don't know if that web ad with Winston Churchill is going to do much for him one way or the other, but I think he's got this moment where he has this luxury of introducing himself to the American people, of telling his story, and I think it's going to disappear sooner than he would like, and so he should really be as aggressive as he can and sort of introducing himself in a positive way to the American people, which is all the more reason why he should probably keep the temper under wraps for a while.
Kellyanne, do you think he's enjoying this Obama-Clinton fight?
He ought to be, and I have to slightly disagree. I don't know that he showed his temper. I mean, it's not like he hauled off and let her have it or called her a monster or a liar like the other two are doing. But she really didn't have a follow-up question, Larry. He sort of politely gave her an opening to change the subject, and she was tongue-tied in doing so. John McCain is in New Orleans tonight addressing the Council on National Policy. It's been reported these are just the cream of the crop conservatives. This is what he's in the scenes now. While Hillary and Obama argue about whether or not she should let him sit on the back of the bus of her presidential ticket, or he argues whether or not she lied us into war in 2002. So there he is doing something out of the headlines for all the argument that if John McCain's not part of the headline and the byline and the storyline now, he's going to suffer. Hey, if the headlines are who's a monster, McCain's better off being in New Orleans addressing these top-of-the-line conservatives.
Larry, we have to address that. We have to address that. This back-of-the-bus comment is just really beyond the pale. I think Senator Clinton, whatever our disagreements are between the two candidates, Senator Clinton has never done or said anything that would imply that she would rather have Barack Obama sitting in the back of her campaign bus.
No, you're not speaking clearly
because that's out of line.
No, she doesn't want him to be the first black president. She wants him to be her VP. She said that this week. She would consider putting him on his ticket, but I guess he would not consider putting her on his ticket, would he?
Did you use the term back of the bus?
I did. I just said she has said that she would have Barack Obama as her VP. Thereby, she is denying something that many Republicans are not denying, that Barack Obama has a very strong chance of becoming this country's first black president. That's something that someone like me respects.
We can move along, but I was there for a lot of Bill Clinton and Al Gore's time, and Al Gore never sat in the back of the bus.
Lisa, how tough a competitor will Senator McCain be?
Oh, I think he'll be a formidable competitor. I mean, there's no doubt about it. But I have to tell you, having watched that ad, Larry, you know, I'm a little surprised. I find it somewhat hollow. Let's remember, I mean, this is a man who said we should stay in Iraq for 100 years. So I'm not sure introducing himself the way he is going to ring true with any American. Secondly, he's aligned himself with a president who's very unpopular. He's got